organization, the way forward is definitely on a PPP model where there's the private sector who is the investor. As you see on this stage, there's Pankaj on that end, there's me on this end, we are the pillars, and there's government in the center. We are all working together, making this platform which will grow. So it is with the city. Pankaj has already said that I came here in 98. Actually, no, we started group housing in 98. The first ever group housing in Noida. Very ambitious, and we dared to invest here. And it's been a nice journey since then. But what I want to say is, so we are working in 7 states. But the experience to work in Noida has by far been the best, because probably it's close to my heart, and it's like we started from here. The entire master planning of this city is incomparable. In fact, the tri-cities, I won't just say Noida, I'll say Noida, Greater Noida, and now even Yamuna Expressway. It's unbeatable. It cannot be matched. We've traveled a lot across the country, and I don't see any other city even coming close to this kind of planning and infrastructure. Imagine in the next 5 years, and I say this to investors, imagine the airport is up and running, the Delhi-Mumbai industrial corridor, starting from Dadri, is right here. You have a connection from IGI to Jewar Airport. Traffic comes into Noida from D&D. You have a different route going to Noida Extension via this flyover, which is going straight to sectors 63, 65, which go further to Noida Extension. And you have the Noida Expressway going to Greater Noida and to Yamuna Expressway. This kind of road network, this kind of infrastructure is unbeatable. Then you have the airport and the DMIC right there. So why would not? And along this road, along both these highways, you already have so much of housing, offices, and as you go forward, you'll have factories, manufacturing, the airport, educational institutions, social infrastructure, malls, just about everything a city could ask for. So there's no way that we cannot have investment in this region. It's a given that even people from Mumbai now are coming here looking for opportunities. I'm talking about real estate developers. The central government is giving a Make in India push, and there's no better place to set up a very focused, dedicated manufacturing hub around this area, be it the Yamuna Expressway or Noida or Greater Noida. This is, it's inevitable because of the connectivity further down to the country, because of GST coming up. Therefore, we are going to have immense warehousing opportunities in this area, lots of manufacturing, and of course, transportation to the rest of the country and to the rest of the world via Jewar Airport and the DMIC take you to the port and et cetera, et cetera. So the opportunities for investment are fantastic, brilliant. As a real estate developer, we've had good experiences here. Coming to the recommendations, you said that we must make about water. Now, water, of course, is a very important thing. But my recommendation, Rituji, is that, you know, like in the West, the value of the raindrop is so, so important. We must make reservoirs over here, lakes and reservoirs, and we had suggested to the central government also. Under every flyover, wherever in the monsoon you see this huge thing, why can we not funnel the water just under the flyover into a small, you know, water body, which actually recharges your groundwater. So we can do this across the city and make, maybe in some areas, make lakes and reservoirs where probably, you know, we can dig out our satellite imaging for the last 30, 35 years. And this is something which I feel, you know, that the city can do and take a lead in that. Second thing is, as real estate developers, and Pankaj, we start doing this now, whatever water we get condensed from the air conditioning in our group housing society, so because it's in a vertical stack, we started taking that water, and that water is distilled water, because in summer and in monsoon, that water comes, it's actually pure water, it's condensation that makes this water, creates this water. So we have started taking this water down to a sump at the basement level, yes, across all towers, and then reusing this water into the main water tanks. So you actually get distilled water to recharge your water tank. I believe a 1.5 ton AC in about 14 hours gives you about 20 liters of water in the monsoon. Yeah, when the weather is very humid. So I think this should be recommended to all office buildings, to all factories wherever air conditioning is being used. to collect this water, which we are right now, we are just letting it go. You know, it's just being drained out. It should be used. It should be collected. And somewhere it should be used for recharging. The third point, which I've always made, and I think Rituji, in one of the meetings we had with you, I said the same thing. We've got lovely infrastructure, but we must somehow educate our people to use the infrastructure also. Because if you have fantastic infrastructure and you're not using it well, people say the Yamuna Expressway, you know, accidents ho rahe hain. Expressway ki kya galti hai? Agar log galat drive kar rahe hain, to accident ho rahe hain, to usme expressway ne kya kiya hai? So I think first and foremost, we should have a pilot project wherein we, at least in these three cities, in the tri-city area of Noida, Greater Noida and Yamuna Expressway, why don't we enforce lane driving, have somebody from the west come in and give demos and probably teach the citizens how to drive in the lanes. So it'll actually be a big, big example for the rest of the country to follow where such good infrastructure is coming up. But we are having accidents over there because of lack of education to use the infrastructure. All in all, I think this is where we started from and this is where we'd like to be at least for the next decade. I see enough opportunity here. Unfortunately, it's been said in the past that Gurgaon is the richer cousin of Noida, but not anymore. We have moved up in brand value vis-a-vis Gurgaon. I think as every citizen, all of us must make it a point to talk positively of this area. The law and order situation, let me assure you, is if not better, it's as good as Delhi or Gurgaon. But unfortunately, the perception in the minds of people from the IT industry, from in the mind of foreigners is that Noida, you know, it's lovely, infrastructure is fantastic, but the law and order, you know, but why? It's not like that really. So we must as citizens, and I request the media, we shall in Kradai, I think Pankaj, we should do a campaign and a roadshow where we showcase that, you know, with numbers and statistics, that it's not, the perception is misplaced. It's wrong. With such infrastructure, with such good opportunities here, we also have a good law and order situation. It can be improved. I'm not saying it can't be improved. Of course it can. But all of us here who live in this region or who get our livelihood from this region must in one voice at every forum promote this area as a safe area. And there is scope for improvement, like I said, but definitely it's no less than any colony in South Delhi or any area in Gurgaon. Thank you so much.